Hey guys, and welcome back to an odd episode of Ni No Kuni. Unlike the rest of my episodes where I'm usually playing the game for story reasons, I am playing the game to complain or vent or, you know what, apologize. We'll go with apologize because that sounds better. In fact, yeah, that's where we're going to say I'm apologizing. So why am I apologizing? Well, fuck. So here's the thing. I am fully now aware that I should not be left alone with an RPG, because when I'm left alone with it and I enjoy it, I tend to go way overboard. And my adventures have now brought me all over the world now, trying to find a single familiar in hopes that it'll let me recruit it so I can have a good tank, because I still can't figure out what the fuck I'm gonna do with fucking Oliver over here. I pretty much have settled on Perliner. I think he's probably gonna be primary for my team. I don't see me getting rid of him. I think he's gonna be like the best thing for this team. Looks like his next form will probably take care of any of the issues I've had with its defenses. So that's next on my list of things, is to just make him evolve. And he's not the only one who's going to be evolving, because almost everybody now is capable of it. And that's kind of the problem. You see, because I keep playing this, because I find some aspect of this game to be intrinsically fun, or at the very least intrinsically interesting, I've turned the game into a bit of a cakewalk. I mean, that's even before we get into like Griffey. Griffey alone probably makes this game kind of stupid, although I need to make Griffey metamorphose. I haven't done it because I was kind of just kneecapping myself. I was like, well, there's no sense in like letting it further evolves, because it's already powerful enough, and at this point it's probably the most broken thing I have. I've kind of have settled on what I'm going to be doing with Swain. I'm thinking this is going to be a Bone Baron. He's going to end up as a Steam Man. It seems like that's the best route, and he's going to be pretty useful too. I'm pretty happy with it. I think this is going to be his overall lineup. I don't have any idea for these two characters. I don't know exactly what I want to do. Technically, if I wanted to be smart, Lumberwood should be here. But then I gotta figure out what these other two slots are gonna be, because I don't quite know. I have Might here just because. I don't know. But as you can see, Catpurse has now outpaced Might by at least some margin. Even if you take away the fact that its magical defense is less, you're still talking about a 165 evasion, which is nothing to sneeze at, and a much higher attack at the same level. So, you know, they're both roughly around the same. Now, granted, if we threw on a similar weapon, let's throw on this. This is similar to what he's already using, right? See? Even if we throw on like a similar weapon, like, so if we kitted him out close to what he should be, yeah, we'll do this. So even if we kitted him out similarly, right, so we put on similar equipment, he's still, his attack is still being beaten out by a solid 20 points. You know, he has better defenses, I'll give him that much, but that should change. So, kind of not sold on keeping Might around long term. In a weird sub-universe, if I were so lucky and I could like capture two of them, I would just have two Lumberwoods, and I'd just have one go one direction, one go the other. I've kind of been debating on going with another one of the skeletons. Like, man, that's a lot of work. I don't know. If I was going to do that, I should have done that from the start. But I wanted to have variety, so I don't really know what I'm going to fill that spot with. So that's a... That's a complex problem I still gotta figure out. For those of you who've played the game, please give me some suggestions. Obviously, Dinoceros is gonna go in my team once I get access to being able to fly. That just seems like a give. Like, that's a gimme. I just don't have a solid third. Right? I just don't have a solid third thing to put there. Once I have that, I'll be fine. I just don't have something solid to put there for right now. Alright, cool. God damn it. This is actually becoming a problem now. My initial plan, like the thing I was gonna do, I don't have any more, I put them all in the sanctuary. I had that, plant thing I picked up before Hamelin, but I was like, yo, this thing, its stats are alright, but man, it's gonna require, like, a lot of effort to get it to, like, a workable place. You know what I mean? Like, for it to be, like, usable, I have to do a lot of effort and, like, level it up and get it even remotely usable. I just don't know if that's really worth my time or not, man. I don't know. I'm still torn on that, so not sure what I'll do there. Nausea was something I was going to do. And I'm starting to ask myself whether or not I should have just rolled a nausea and just rolled it down the magical path. But I don't necessarily know if it's magically inclined, though. That's the problem. Because everyone seems to say nausea is really good for, as a physical striker. But I don't really need another physical striker here. I'm going to have at least two. I'm going to have, Puss as my all-rounder. Dinocero to just blow shit up. I mean, do I need anything else at that point? Probably not. Ugh. I don't know. I am unsure what to do. Unsure entirely. Good lord. God damn it. Will this damn thing just spawn already? Christ. Oof. No. Oof. Oh, wait, no, don't do that. Oh, God. Alright, cool. God, we barely got through that shit. Thankfully, Tin Man is a Iron Man's a fucking glass cannon. Terrible stats, man. Terrible stats. Real damn shame. Alright. Maybe it's there now? No? Okay. You slightly win, game. You slightly win. I've exhausted most of my resources in this idiotic venture. Maybe I'll go another skeleton, bro. But like, do I need that though? One sec. It's like one fucking second. Like, Bone Brigadier. Alright, let's see here. So we got Bone Brigadier. What is this guy's fucking gimmick? Okay, so he's like a support. I might go Bone Brigadier. He seems like he's mostly just a support. Okay, that might be what I do. I'll have a Bone Baron and a Bone Brigadier. At least I can fill the spot for right now. I'm not too worried about Esther, right? Like, there's no need to worry about Esther. I haven't had to worry about her yet. Fuck me, I got fuck. I gotta go all the way fucking back. God damn it. Well, at least nothing's gonna attack me. I'm sorry, guy. I'm sorry. This has been fucking 35 hours, man, and I still can't figure out a good team. I still can't pin that shit down. You'd think I'd have it figured out by now, but I don't. I don't have that shit figured out at all. So, I'm gonna have to try to figure out exactly what the hell I'm gonna do. Maybe I'll just go 2. I'll do that. And then I'll just have to figure out... I still want a Lumberwood, though. Like, I'm not gonna give up on that. I think that is a worthwhile investment for Esther. Because I think once I do that, she'll be finished, right? Griffy... She has Griffy, she'll have her bird... Her caster bird, who's been like integral to my team, and between that and having a good tank, do I make it a tank? Well, I technically have a healer, right? Like, I don't need to have another healer. That just doesn't Strongo. Let me take a look here. What are my options with Strongo? Because if I'm gonna waste my time. It's a Florongo seems to be the way people tend to go. And that looks like it's... Yeah, that's a mixture between, like... Heals, Storm Attacks, Light Attacks. Yeah, looks like Florongo is going to be the way I go for this. For that character, at least. I think that's the way we're going to go. Don't know when this is gonna go up. Probably this will be the next episode I upload. Just so you guys can get an idea of just like how stupid this playthrough's been. I apologize for being busted and overpowered and broken. But that's what you get when you give me an RPG map. You guys would have figured that shit out by now with fucking Final Fantasy IX. Maybe I was wrong, guys. Maybe I fucked up. Well, bright side is, if I go out of my way to collect this particular one, it shouldn't take me that long. I mean, granted, I'm going to have to catch him all the way up, but he doesn't have to technically be used, right? Like, I don't have to technically use him. At least not for a while. I can just hold off. Is it more effective for me to grab him? Does it matter? It's probably going to be quicker for me to grab it this way than to grab the evolved form anyways, right? Because the evolved form will likely have a lower persuade rate. So doing it this way, at least there's a higher chance I'll actually be able to grab him. Fancy your chances, do you? But Bone Rager would already be there, so where can I get Bone Rager? Well, that's dumb, right? Bone Ranger should be where? Ghostly Gore. Oh yeah, I know where that is. I know exactly where they are. Okay. Then we're not gonna collect it here. We'll go straight to the source and collect the second form. Cause that'll already be at like level 10. And at least that's only like 20 levels I gotta do to catch it up. I kinda hate myself, honestly. Not like in a personal way where I might do something to myself, but in like a I wish I had done my research and made this less frustrating for myself. So if I'm lucky, I'll just get them first try and we'll be done. Here goes nothing. Who are you running from right now? I know you ain't running from me. Well, bright side is... The rest of the effort I'm gonna have to go through won't be that hard. Because these aren't rare spawns. Unlike the Lumberwood, which is an incredibly rare spawn. But at least those guys have the decency to occasionally pop up in pairs. I don't think that helps my odds that much, though. Tin Man is like really bad. But I don't see it. Like, I can see why they'd come to that conclusion. Kinda. God damn it. Oh god, this is going to be a fucking nightmare, isn't it? God, this is... God, it's Pokemon, but with worse odds. Yes, yes, we did. We did it. Alright? Oh, god damn it. Well, Esther, at least you caught up. I'll give you that much. God. Apparently there's a fourth, another party member I'm going to be getting soon. Yeah, spoiler alert. I'm not committing myself to that. Nah, fuck that. Absolutely fuck that. That's not happening. I am not doing it. Okay. What is the odds of a Bone Ranger fucking cooperating with me right now? 4.8. Okay. Bone Brigadier. Okay. What's your odds? Oh, well, that's the wrong one. Right. Bonehead. That's his name. What's Bonehead's chance? 6%. Really? 6%. You're telling me the odds of me getting what I want right now are between a 4.8% and a 6%. That is some actual garbage. That is some hot mess garbage. So, at like 4.8%. How many of these do I actually have to kill before one of them decides, like, hey, this guy, he doesn't have much of a life. They'll be serenaded regardless. Or I'll have a chance to serenade them. And thankfully, the game is nice enough to not, like, let my team accidentally kill them. Oh, finally. Ugh. God damn. Alright, so that's part of the work, right? Oh no. Oh no, that's the wrong thing. Nice. 4.8% my ass. Do I want to go for Lumberwood? Skullator? Skillectric? Yes. Yes. See? Level 10. So he's already better than... So now I can get rid of you. You're no longer necessary. Because I now have someone who'll be playing a support role. Because technically... The thing he's gonna become will be a more support-focused role. And if I recall, let's see here. Bone Brigadier. Because technically, he's already kind of a supporty-ish one. But he learned Sabotage, Blunt, Yo-Ho, fucking Warcry. And I don't think... Maybe his other one learns it too. Bone Baron. Does Bone Baron learn... No, Bone Baron does not learn Warcry. So yeah, Warcry alone almost justifies his existence. So yeah. He'll be... sticking around. So we got one more thing up my sleeve, and that is to go capture this fucking piece of wood if I can actually do it. God, this is actually going to be a nightmare. Well, it is almost 1 a.m. And let's face it, I don't want to stop until I catch the thing I want. Because at that point, it's just going to be me re-leveling everything, so I might as well finish it out. Why am I in fact doing it this way? Why aren't I just going through and leveling them now? Why am I choosing to wait? Honestly, it's really just because there's no real, I don't have a really strong reason for it. It's a rare spawn, and I've only seen it spawn in one very particular place. I don't know if they can spawn on other points of this island. Obviously, that's possible. Yeah, he's there right now. But I don't know how to get him to spawn faster. It seems like if I leave for a bit and come back, he usually tends to spawn. Alright. I'm still faster than you. Fantastic. Let's play Curse. Let's see just how much you're gonna fuck me on this. Give me two. If there's two of them, at least it doubles my... Okay, good. There's two of them. It doubles my odds. Alright. Let's see how lucky we are. That's one. Come on. Come on. Damn it. If I recall, I think his odds are really low. Like, criminally low. This is... This is actually gonna be a fucking problem. Alright. I mean, I want it, right? Alright. I'll keep trying. Oh my god. Ugh. What can I say? Good lord. That was almost an hour by itself. I had, like, mused at the idea of gathering up two of them, But nah, fuck that. Absolute fuck that. From the bottom of my achy breaky fucking heart. Fuck. Oh, Jesus. Is this fucker gonna be slow to level? Because if he's starting at level 1, this is boding very badly. One second. I swear to God, if this thing is slow to level, I'm going to be... Okay. Early growth rate. The familiar experience is an easier early game, but harder late game. Oh, okay. So, yeah. Some of you might be wondering, why did I go through such a fucking trial and tribulation to get this fucker? I'll tell you why. Because, now that I have him, Esther over here will probably never die. She is probably set for life, and this fucker isn't gonna die. Not sure what I'll do for armor specifically, because that just lowers his accuracy. And its baseline stats are actually fairly good, so it's not exactly a situation where I want him to have bad stats, so I'll go from there. Anyways, everybody, yeah, we're done. I'm gonna go save and go to bed. It's almost 2:00 in the morning. I really should have went to bed hours ago, but I was determined to do this. Till then, everybody, stay tuned. I am signing out. Fuck, I still gotta level up all these fucking familiars too. God damn it. This is going to be a fucking shit show. Oh well. I mean, I asked for it. Fuck it, we'll get it done. I always do. Anyways, guys, till then, stay tuned. I'm signing out.